and Zhuge Liang, two brilliant strategists that had emerged in a chaotic age. Since battling together at Shibi, the two had exchanged heated strategies, one after another. And for now, the sleeping dragon had once again returned to its slumber. To divide the land into two, the strategy that Zhou Yu had envisioned was finally realized. The only remaining enemy was Cao Cao. The battles in the near future would no doubt prove to be even more intense than those thus far. Yet Zhou Yu headed for the location of the veteran officers with a smile on his face. More than anything else, he looked forward to sharing drinks with those he had fought together with in battle.
This plan that you envisioned, a land of two parts, has somewhat taken shape.
Yes, though it did require some time. Now we can face off against Cao Cao without too much worry.
If we had first suppressed Yi Province, these two parts would have formed much earlier. But you refused to listen to my suggestions and chose to form an alliance with Liu Bei.
Uncontrolled zeal will only end up burning yourself and those closest to you. Fool that I am. I only realized this after losing an irreplaceable friend. I will never make the same mistake twice. That's why I have suppressed these overflowing feelings and chosen the benefits gained from siding with Liu Bei.
Ha! You say that, but I saw you at that banquet. Those feelings quite overflowed that night.
Ah! So Master Chang Pu was able to see right through me. It looks like I still have quite a ways to go.
I'm quite jealous of the two of you. No one now would be able to tell that you were once at one another's throats.
Why are you bringing that up? Zhou Yu, bring out your zither later. You can play for me while I drink.
Of course. It would be my pleasure. Well then, I'll have to think about what to play this evening.